Can creatine supplements help depression? You would think so by all the talk this is getting online, but what's the real proof? That's what I'm going to show you in this video. So creatine is a naturally produced organic compound. It's mostly known for its ability to improve muscle power and is synthesized from the amino acids arginine, glycine, and methionine. Now, while creatine is mostly manufactured in the liver and the kidneys, it's also synthesized in the brain, which is interesting because the brain makes up only about 2% of your body weight. However, it accounts for about 20% of your basal metabolic rate. In other words, the brain uses a lot of energy, and this is intriguing because some have proposed that depression is caused by imbalances in the energy stores within the brain. It's an interesting idea, and there is some animal research suggesting there may be something to this. However, the real proof is what happens when you give people with depression creatine supplements. Well, in one of the first clinical trials on this topic, 10 people with major depression who were not responding to conventional medications were given creatine monohydrate supplements for 4 weeks in addition to their medications. Now, while this study started with 10 people, I want you to know that 3 of them dropped out, and that leaves 7 people who completed this trial. Of those 7 people, 5 of them showed about a 50% improvement in their Hamilton depression scores. And one more thing, most of these improvements were said to occur within the first week of creatine supplementation. And what makes this study a little more intriguing is that 2 of those 5 people reported that their depression got worse once they stopped taking creatine supplements. A few years later takes us to this clinical trial where 5 teenage girls with depression who were also taking antidepressant medications were given creatine supplements for 8 weeks. Results of this trial likewise indicated that their depression scores improved by over 50% by the end of the study. Brain imaging scans also indicated that their levels of phosphocreatine in the brain also increased as well compared to healthy people who did not take creatine supplements. And that brings us to this study, which may be the very first randomized clinical trial of creatine for depression. For 8 weeks, 39 women with depression are given either SSRI medications or SSRI meds with a placebo. The data revealed that adding creatine supplements to the medication led to better and faster improvements in depression compared to those people who only took the SSR meds by themselves. In other words, creatine seemed to help the antidepressant medications work better. Now, in this next interesting experiment, 14 women with depression who were not responding to their medications were given a combination of creatine monohydrate plus 200 milligrams of 5-hydroxytryptophan, which is a supplement that can raise serotonin levels. 8 weeks later, it's reported that depression scores improved in these people by between 60 and 65%. It's also reported that most people felt these supplements worked so well that they continued to take either creatine or 5-HTP after the study had concluded. Okay, sounds good so far. However, you need to know that not everything is perfect here. In this paper, 14 women with major depression who were not responding to their medications were given creatine supplements in addition to their meds. 4 weeks later, it's reported that there were no significant improvements in depression scores, although they do point out that 2 of the 14 women showed improvements in depression by about 50%. And while that is encouraging, it also means that creatine didn't work in the remaining 12 women in this study. There's also this clinical trial, which lasted 8 weeks and involved 23 people with bipolar disorder. While creatine did appear to improve depression scores by over 50%, the results did not reach clinical significance. Here's a table that summarizes the results of the studies I just reviewed and some studies I did not mention. Feel free to stop the video and take a closer look at the results. Okay, so let's cut to the chase here. Here's my thoughts on the creatine depression research. Now, the first thing I'll point out is that most of these clinical trials involve only women or mostly women, which means we really do need more research on how men with depression might respond to creatine. My instinct is they probably would respond similarly if this research is to be believed. However, I want to see that data to know for sure. Another thing to know is that these papers contain small numbers of people. Most don't contain placebo groups. And having read these papers, I think some of them have problems. And also, in my own personal opinion, I think some of them are sloppy. Does creatine make bipolar disorder worse? This was mentioned in some of the papers that I saw where some individuals who had bipolar disorder actually either developed mania or hypomania after taking creatine supplements. Now, while most people with bipolar didn't have these problems, if you have this condition and you're thinking of creatine supplements, I really think it's important for you to talk to your psychiatrist, doctor, and pharmacist to get the most up-to-date information for you. As I was reviewing this research, I noticed that more than one clinical trial was using a specific brand of creatine called CreaPure. And while that may raise red flags to some people who are watching this video, I want you to know that no conflicts of interest were reported in any of the clinical trials I saw. While I personally want to see larger and better performed clinical trials, if creatine really does help depression, these studies indicate that it's probably going to start to work within a month or two.